Kalau ada Chef Siti, mesti nak kena ada resepi. Betul tak?
Of course lah.
So cikgu, what are we going to do today?
What are you going to do?
Eh wait, we haven't explained to them why I call you cikgu.
Kenapa yes. call cikgu? Tu mesti nak cakap kenapa you panggil cikgu? Kenapa yes. bukan Chef Siti?
Betul. Yeah. So because sebenarnya I've been a student of cikgu for the longest time. I'm not one of the first few students, but I've learned from you since 2013.
Wow.
2013. So it's been 9 years
wow.
since.
Hidayah ni sudah jadi anak murid saya semenjak tahun 2013. Lama tu. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sure kalau 2013 tu mesti you dah lupa somewhere along the line dah lupa nak buat apa lah kan. So hari ni cikgu nak test sikit.
Memang malu.
Nak test. Okay. Kita buat apa hari ni?
Okay, we're gonna do walnut cupcake. Tak, bukan. Walnut muffin kan? Walnut cupcake. Sorry.
Walnut cupcakes. Itulah. Walnut cupcakes. Okay,
yes.
Walnut cupcakes. Cupcakes memang kesukaan ramai lah kan? Okay, ni cikgu nak test lah eh. Apa perbezaan cupcake dengan muffin? Ni soalan cepu mas. Selalu orang tanya tu.
Kenapa? I knew this was coming.
So, did you do your homework and check?
A little bit, okay. Yes. Takkan depan cikgu tak buat homework.
Apa dia?
Okay, so muffins, they are a little bit heavier.
Lebih padat.
As compared to cupcakes. Cupcake is usually lighter.
Okay.
And muffin usually don't have toppings on top.
Masih ingat.
Yes.
Okey, jom kita mula. Bagi mereka yang inginkan resepi ni, anda harus lihat dan kita akan beritahu resepinya. Sudah pun ditulis tadi di boardnya. Rumah dia canggih tu. Dekat fridge dia boleh tulis apa-apa yang kita nak. Seronok sekali. Okey, come let's mula.
So we have the butter here.
Okay.
Which is 170 gram. So kita masukkan butter dulu.
Yep, butter.
One tip when we are going to do creaming method or when we're going to use a mixer, the butter must be cold. Because when we put the butter in and the machine starts turning, it's going to melt the butter bit by bit. So if we're going to use room temperature butter, then it will melt even faster. So that's one tip for you. Okay, butter.
Cikgu kalau nak test, cikgu tak boleh lah. You tak boleh tanya cikgu. Cikgu nak tengok.
Okay. Ada stress mode on.
Okay, so gula kita kena pakai caster sugar.
120 grams.
Okay. Kan dia putar sendiri.
Oh, yeah.
Kan?
It moves by itself.
Yes, it moves by itself. I love it. And this one kan, pasal ni lah. Nanti dia very even tau.
Okay.
So butter ni sejuk. Jadi kita pakai low speed dulu.
Right.
Okay, slowly we can increase slightly higher.
Okay, so maybe just like 1 minute.
Yeah, one minute.
This is speed two.
Yes. Okay, biar dia pukul.
Okay.
We're gonna use walnuts. So whenever you have nuts, please pre-bake. Kita bakar dulu, eh?
So for this recipe, we use 5 eggs. The eggs needs to be small. Am I right,
Yes.
Cikgu?
Yeah.
Yes. Yay! I passed at something.
Many of us do not realize the importance of the size of the eggs when you're doing cakes or pastries or bread, okay? So the size of the eggs matters. If you're to do cookies and you use large eggs, what will happen to your cookies? It'll be very flat and it will not be crunchy as compared to when you use small eggs. Okay, kita masukkan vanilla sikit. Boleh taruh kat telur,
okay? So vanilla essence is 1/4 teaspoon. Cikgu pakai ni agak-agak. Okay, that's better actually.
Cikgu pakai letak je.
Actually, it doesn't matter because more vanilla essence is nicer, isn't it?
Okay, macam mana kita nak tahu this is okay?
I know, I remember.
Okay,
jom tengok. Okay, kita stop dulu. Okay, I know.
Test this.
We have to scrape off a bit below. And see the color change.
Okay.
It has to be a bit lighter.
Okay.
Usually lighter. Creaming method, the butter has to be lighter than this.
Okay.
So this is not done yet.
I'm going to show the camera.
Yeah.
Okay. So is this done yet? It's not right because masih ada dua warna. So
yes.
Whenever kita buat cupcakes ke muffins ke, kita kena berhentikan dan kita kena scrape. Bila kita nak masukkan telur, most recipes will say masukkan sebiji kan. So it's best to put dalam 2 to 3 edition saja.
2 to 3.
Pasal apa? Kalau kita masukkan sebiji dia 5 biji tau. Baratan 5 biji ni dah cair.
Okay,
so we're going to add in bit by bit.
Okay. So we put at speed 1. Okay. And then we go 1 2.
Now. 2 editions can be Like that. It doesn't have to be one egg.
Okay. Got it.
Okay. That's a short one.
Now we can.
Okay. Jangan pakai high speed. Okay. I'm just going to stir this a bit.
Okay.
This gaulkan dia. Okay. Now, just a gentle reminder, this is not a baking class lah. Bukan baking class, tapi kita nak share the final tips about baking. Okay?
Yes,
so now this is what we call the curdle stage, which is normal. Ramai, okay, curdle stage ni kan, ramai yang kadang-kadang ingatkan dah rosak. Sebenarnya tak, it's normal.
Okay.
Bila kita taruh tepung, dia dah okay.
Dia dah okay lah.
Okay. Tepung, dayak eh. Kita masukkan dengan baking powder.
Okay, so this one we can just put all, right?
Yep.
Okay, with baking powder.
Kita pakai low speed eh, Daya.
Okay.
Ada habis.
Kita berbedak lagi.
Berbedak lagi.
Okay.
Low speed.
Okay. Okay. Got it?
Nice.
Oh yes, now with the curdle stage, with the flour then, you can see it coming together.
Yes, correct.
Very nice.
Okay, now you add in the kacang.
Kacang.
Okay. Kacang kan kita tak payah pakai mesin tau.
Okay.
Kita fold in aja. Cikgu masukkan sikit lah.
Okay.
Ini yang lain kita letak tabur atas eh.
Alright.
Okay. And chocolate rice.
Okay.
Okay, masukkan.
This is nice. And this one can be all right?
Yep.
Okay.
Kalau y'all tengok Hidayah ni kan, dia macam dah selesa sangat. Dia actually, she's not a baker. Kan? So
yeah,
let's get to know her a little bit more. Just tell the audience a little bit. Apa pekerjaan you yang pertama?
Okay. So right after A levels, I actually joined SQ.
Oh,
SIA.
Wow.
So I was working as an air stewardess for 2 years.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But being very young, I thought that, you know, I could probably explore a little bit more beyond flying.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but I just didn't feel that I wanted to do it for a long-term career.
Ah, okay.
Yes. So I went back to school and I did my diploma in physiotherapy.
Physiotherapy.
Yes.
Wow.
So by profession, by training, I am actually a trained physiotherapist.
Wow. Jadi kalau dorang nak services of orang kira-kira physiotherapy services, boleh lah.
InsyaAllah, boleh.
You memang bikin house calls lah kan?
Yes, I do.
Jadi bila you buat physio tu kan, untuk more kepada untuk tua lah.
More for the untuk tua, betul. And it was quite labor intensive. So
nak kena dokong kan?
Betul, yes.
Asi?
So at the same time, while I was doing physiotherapy, it was also the period that I was gonna get married. And at that time, harga rumah melambung. Melambung tinggi.
Okay.
Yeah. And then I thought, why not I learn how to handle housing transactions myself?
Oh my God.
Yeah.
So for you, you actually dah... You see that if there's a need to learn,
yes,
you pergi belajar.
Betul.
So you nak you nak dapatkan rumah,
mm-hmm,
and you nak elakkan bayar mahal-mahal, yelah.
Betul.
All the unnecessary transactions. So I you belajar.
Not only that, I mean agent fee is one thing, but I feel that I have to know how the transaction goes,
yes,
because
correct.
I think that's important. Jadi that's why I feel knowledge, lifelong learning, very important.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Lifelong learning. Yep, you're talking the lifelong learner award winner.
That's why we have a lot of things in common actually.
Yes,
right?
Yeah, actually that's why. That's the reason also kita cerita kita ni dipanggil a tale of two cities.
Yes.
Sebab kita banyak cerita.
Mm-hmm.
We have lots and lots of tales to share with everyone. So that's why we decided to call it a tale of two cities.
Yes.
Actually kan Hidayah.
Yep.
A tale of two cities ni dia ada cerita kan?
Buku actually, I think.
Buku,
there used to be a book on it.
Oh, okay.
The book is called The Tales of Two Cities. So it's
C-I-T-I-E-S.
That's
right. Tapi kalau pronunciation,
correct.
Cities lah.
Yes. Okay. Because coincidentally, both of us are cities.
Yes.
So I'm Siti Nur Hidayah and she is Siti Mastura.
Yes. So sekarang, you I would say your full-time job will be what?
Okay, so now, right now, I am dabbling full-time in real estate. Yeah, because that has kept me busy, alhamdulillah. I'm also working in a team right now.
Okay.
So our team is called SMZDBB.
SMZ.
Okay, so the long form of it is
okay.
Siti Muzaidin Batisa Bros. Familiar tak you?
Wow, dia kerja dengan Taufik you. Oh. Taufik, I'm a fangirl. I'm a fangirl of Taufik.
Tak boleh sebut Taufik ya, Bati Sabro saja dah tahu.
Oh, itulah. Yeah. Oh, kalau cikgu nak anu rumah boleh, tapi cikgu nak minta Taufik yang attend.
Oh, boleh. No problem.
Saja je kan. Fangirl tapi, lah katakan.
Oh, yes. Don't worry, nanti I'll show you the sing for you sekali.
Okay, kita letak kacang lah kat atas.
Oh yes, kacang.
Kacang sikit kat atas. So kacang tadi kita tinggalkan sikit. Yep. Lepas kita nak letak kat atas.
Okay. Oh yeah, then it'll be beautiful.
Yeah, you taruh, you taruh.
Okay.
Ni I'm so supposed to test you, kenapa aku yang buat eh?
Itulah.
Kan, tiba-tiba kan.
Okay. Nice. I can just spread it around. Yep. Right.
No. Kalau muffin yang kecil kan, Daria, kita mungkin 20 minit. Ni agak besar tau. So we'll go about 25, 30 kalau besar gini eh.
Okay.
Kita taruh dulu 25. Kalau 25. Perlu, dan kita tambah.
Okay.
Habiskanlah, jangan lukis.
Ya, habis. Because I personally... Kacang. Oh, yeah, same. Sama kita. Kita sama je.
Kita suka. Ada kopi kan nanti?
Oh, definitely. Yes. My husband is a coffee lover.
Ah.
He has so many kinds of machine. So, okay, cool. Yes, he will make us the coffee later.
Okay. Okay, okay, so we're done.
Yes.
So, kita akan bakar. Ada khidmat ke atau produk-produk yang you all nak kita pertengahkan, jangan malu dengan segan, bagi tahu kita ajalah. Nanti kita boleh ketengahkan.
Yes, correct. Just let us know.
Hingga kita jumpa di episod yang satu lagi. Bye.
Saya cakap apa-apa.